Greetings, welcome to this week's Primed Insight. I'm Gavin Gooden and this is Brian Hewitt from RTB. Today we're looking at the Radex filter. This is the breathing air filter that you use for breathing air when you're blasting or painting using a supplied air respirator like a Nova helmet. The way these work is you bring your air in from your compressor or your air dryer in the side. It comes around through a screen and up through the filter. You can see here it's got several layers of different things. This is carbon in the middle, which removes smells and moisture. And these filters have to be replaced every 3 months because of the moisture that gets inside from your breathing air. We also recommend you replace your canister regularly because they do get grease and dirt and oil around the outside. And when you're changing these out, you never know what could happen. The air comes out through the top. You regulate your pressure here. You can feed two airlines or you can feed down into your CO monitor. I'm going to turn over to Brian here to talk about the CO monitor.
Thanks, Gavin. So with the RPB GX4 gas monitor, it is a very unique piece of equipment and it has a lot of safety benefits for you while you're doing your work. The first benefit for you with the GX4 is as this is looking for carbon monoxide or it's logging information, it's also saving it so that you can go back and have a log of the information when the unit was turned on and when it was turned off or when there was alarms. You now have visibility to that information and it saves the information for up to 24 months. Also, the PPM level, if we talk about carbon monoxide, the set PPM level is 10. So that amount cannot be changed. That is a safety feature so that your operator are never exposed or the alarm does not go off other than at over 10 PPM. We also do have a oxygen sensor and also an H2S sensor to further protect your operators. You also have a clear tube that will help you detect any oil or moisture that might be getting past your oil filter. And also, this unit can be mounted in a case for harsh environments. And another benefit is that this unit never has to leave the field. You can do calibration checks on your own with the onboard wizard that steps you through the process, and it's very easy to do, and we recommend you do that on a monthly basis. I trust that was helpful, and I'll turn it back to you, Gavin, for any further comments.
That's good, Brian. So if I'm in the field and I need to replace the sensor, is there a way to do that easily, or do I have to send them back to you?
No, so the sensor comes from the factory pre-calibrated, mm-hmm. And they pop in and out very easily, much like an inkjet printer. So you will get an alarm 10 days before it expires that will tell you that you need to replace it, and they contact you to get a new one. And then when it comes, you take the old one out and you pop the new one in and you're back in business.
Wow, that really saves me time.
Sure does.
Thanks for watching this week's Primed Insight. We'll see you next week.